Hi, I'm Rose with Plytix, and welcome to Lesson 2 of the Plytix Academy Certification on Syndication. In the previous lesson, you learned about what syndication is and why it's important. So now that you know, let's talk about the differences between traditional syndication versus syndication now. What I mean by traditional syndication is the way most businesses have been distributing or sharing data, manually. Let's take a peek at what this looks like. Imagine you're the owner of a shoe store that's been in your family for generations. When the business began, no one had even dreamed of the internet yet. All the shoes your family sold were purchased by customers who came into the shop and bought them in person. Product information was easy to manage because the product selection was limited and the information was only used for internal reference. People could easily choose which shoes they wanted to buy from your store because they could see, touch, and try them on. Fast forward to today, and things have gotten a lot more complex. The internet became a thing, and so did buying and selling products online. First, you created your own web shop to sell your shoes. Since online buyers can't physically touch, pick up, and try on your products, you had to really paint a picture for them. This meant adding detailed information for each shoe. Whereas before, all you needed to manage was basic information like product ID, size, and color, now you needed to create descriptions, size charts, include various pictures, and so on. At this point, you're managing this information in a spreadsheet and Dropbox account, or directly in the web shop itself, because again, you're really only needing to syndicate that data to one place, right? That is, until you wanted to increase the average purchase value and decided to expand your online store by selling products from other brands. That's when the spreadsheets really started flying. Now, you're dealing with a lot more information, some of which you get from your suppliers. Thing is, you can't really control how suppliers send that information. Some of them send you a catalog, which you pick products from. Some send you a spreadsheet or product sheet with basic information of the products you purchased. And others might not send you anything apart from an invoice. Trust me, it happens. The ones that do send information have their own terminology. A product's label might be product name, title, or short description. The product color might be light blue, baby blue, or sky blue. When it comes time to upload your information to your webshop, you'll need to either edit the spreadsheets provided to you or create a whole new one that matches the requirements of the e-commerce platform that hosts your webshop. So let's say you get information from 5 providers, plus your own products, that's already at least 6 spreadsheets that you now need to manage. This is where a PIM system becomes handy. Even though we're only uploading this information into one platform, when you're dealing with information from various sources, the risk of inconsistent data becomes a lot higher. Think about when your suppliers change their pricing. That's a new sheet. Or when shipping costs increase, new sheet. Or when a line is out, new sheet. Now, let's throw marketplaces into the mix. Let's say you decide to expand your webshop into selling at marketplaces in order to reach a wider audience. I know the first one that comes to most people's mind is Amazon, so let's start there. Amazon, like every other marketplace or e-commerce platform, has its own requirements for what product information can be imported and how. Plus, if you want to rank higher in search results, you can't just use the same product descriptions for every platform. That goes against every SEO best practice. And let's not forget digital assets. When it comes to assets, each product has images, videos, 3D graphics, and documents, and each platform has its own requirements when it comes to file size, file type, and even how you include these. For example, maybe your gallery of lifestyle photos is saved in PNG format, but your sales channel will only accept images in JPG. Turns out, you need another spreadsheet to keep track of asset attributes and locations. This also means you can't just take the product information you have on your webshop as is and upload it directly onto Amazon. You'll need to edit and add to it in order to fit Amazon's structure and requirements. And each time you need to update your listings, you'll either have to do it manually or update the CSV used to import your data. So, yet another sheet to keep updated. When the shoes your family once sold out of a brick and mortar store can now be bought by people all over the world, from your Shopify store, Amazon, Foot on Mars, StockX, Sprinter, Zalando, or from countless other vendors, in order for you to sell that same pair of shoes, you need to send your photos, description, pricing, etc. to 5, 6, who knows how many different places. That translates to, you guessed it, a whole separate spreadsheet for each vendor, which can mean multiple versions of the same spreadsheet, as well as having multiple people or departments trying to work with the same data. Having to maintain so many versions of that data makes it difficult to keep your product listings consistent and accurate, which in turn can lead to a poor user experience. When you use a product information management tool like Plytix, you can centralize and manage all of your product data from one place, keeping data consistent and easy to manage. But in addition to being a single source of truth for your product data and assets, many PIMs actually help you with syndication as well. Take, for example, the channels tool that we offer in Plytix. The way this tool works is pretty simple. In short, you define an output and select which information you want to send, then the system creates a data feed for it, which I'll explain more about in a minute. This data feed then fetches information from your Plytix account, so you only need to maintain one set of data. This can save you a significant amount of time and effort compared to manually entering the data for each channel. Let's take a deeper look into how this works. The first step is to define the kind of output you want the feed to be. This depends on the requirements of where you're planning to syndicate to. Once you've chosen the type of output you want, the next step is to choose what information you want to include. You're probably thinking, if I have to choose the information, how exactly is this any different than creating a new spreadsheet? There are two main differences. The first is, if the place you're sending data to, this could be a platform or a client, provides a template, you can upload this template to any CSV or XLSX channel to simplify the process of choosing the correct data to share. For each field a platform requires, you choose the corresponding attribute you already have stored in Plytix. After that, you just select the products you want to syndicate using a list you've curated, or you can choose a smart list, which automatically includes all products that meet a criteria you set. But let's say you're syndicating your data somewhere like Google Shopping or WooCommerce. Some of your product information may look different from the way it's displayed in their product listing guidelines. Well, Plytix channels allow you to make adjustments to output labels to match naming conventions and transform your data in bulk with computed attributes. For example, let's say your supplier just increased prices temporarily due to a fuel increase. You can quickly increase the prices you want to send by creating a computed attribute that multiplies the price attribute by whatever percentage you want. So here, I just changed the prices for hundreds of products in one go. The last step is processing the channel. That's where the second main difference of using Plytix channels versus manually syndicating data comes in. You've chosen the product list and attributes you want to syndicate. Traditionally, you'd need to copy and paste the values for each of these over to a new sheet. But Plytix automates this. It fetches all of that information from your account and puts it into a file, which can be accessed via a URL. This is known as a product feed URL. What's more is that now you've set this one, you don't need to come back and update the values whenever you make changes to products. You can actually set your channel to update with new product information automatically, every few hours, every day, or on a certain day of the week, ensuring your data feed is always up to date. Just like that, what was once several copies of Excel files is now a tidy URL containing all your latest product information, ready to share. So now that you've automated the process of creating and maintaining spreadsheets, you need to syndicate. But how do you actually syndicate? The next three lessons will explore how to take this feed output you've created and syndicate data, either using product feed URLs, product feed files, and direct integrations. So make sure to subscribe to our channel and click that bell button so you're notified when these lessons come out. See you in the next lesson.